Hello, everyone, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is your girl, Essence E, and this is the home for news and exclusive interviews. And today, I am going to be interviewing the beautiful actress Robin Lee. She has starred in movies such as Girlfriends United, Deceptive Intentions, and The Struggle Part 2, The Dilemma. So let's take a preview of one of her movies that I really loved, and it was Girlfriends United. Let's watch this.
This will be a time when me and my girls kicked it all the way from uptown to downtown. I'm talking till the sun came up. Man, I gotta find him. It gotta be a way.
Remember that time when that boy let his dog off the leash and it started chasing us down the street?
I can't get no mud on my shoes. I'm Jack B, you know.
We have our whole lives ahead of us. I'm sure we'll figure something out. Best friends always.
All I gotta do is just Google their names and something is gonna happen.
I'm trying to reach one of your employees, my friend Stacy.
She don't know me, Stacy.
She really don't know me.
She doesn't know me.
Hold on.
Don't you walk up on me like that. Who the hell are you?
I'm just here to help, baby. Damn, put the gun down.
Look, boom! And I'm gonna definitely plan to seize the opportunity. Hey, my music mean the world to me.
And you best believe it's gonna be plenty loose booty up in that crib. So don't be acting like we're in the church, because there ain't gonna be no praise in the Lord.
Oh my God, where is the security?
Where is she?
These people crazy as hell.
Where is
she?
Motivation and talent. What more could I ask for? I'm loving this, Jack B. I love how you represent.
Mr. Ron Freestyle!
Guys, fresh new sound.
And that chick from the pool party, gon' get her ass whooped. One thing about me, I don't play no games.
Ooh, I don't think I need to be showing all this thickness. I need to tie up my cover up.
When I first saw you, I thought you was so fine. But when I smelled that barrette, smelling like you been eating booty.
I'm sure we'll figure it out. Whatever we decide to be, as long as we got each other, we're gonna be A1. Best friends always.
And now let's bring on the beautiful Robin Lee. Hey, how are you today?
I am great. How are you?
I'm doing well. I want to apologize to everyone for streaming, because everyone knows what streaming is like. And sometimes you have technical difficulties. So my apologies for everything. So
it is totally fine. I get it.
Trust me. So I'm glad you are on my show today. You are such a beautiful inspiration. When I heard about you, I was like, I would love to interview her, because she is really awesome. I looked at your films and they're awesome. So, you know, and now I want to congratulate you, because you're on TV One now. And that is really, really awesome. So let's talk about that. And that's so amazing. So tell us, what are you working on, and when can we see your show on TV One?
Okay. First, I want to thank you so much. I really appreciate this. But thank you so much. TV One. Well, let's see. Can I really talk about that? But you can expect me on TV One soon in an episode. So it's episodic. I can say that.
Okay.
When I can give you guys more information about that, or, you know, put it on social media, then I can do that. So as of right now, you can expect me on TV One, and I'm very excited about that. So
that is so awesome. So how did you feel by playing these two, being a powerful woman in two of your last roles? You play such a powerful woman on both of your roles, like on the Girlfriends United, the Struggle, the Dilemma, which is my favorite. I watched that. I was like, that was deep. So talk about that. How does it feel?
Well, first, I gotta say, you have to get in character for both of them. So especially The Struggle 2, The Dilemma, and Girlfriends Reunited, which was very fun working with every cast member, even the director and everybody, the whole crew. It was just so fun. So just me, I'm fun anyway. So it wasn't hard getting into character for that. So I'm usually studying the script, getting into character. And when I'm on set, I'm already there in that character, in that mode. And so Girlfriend Reunited, it was fun. There were emotional times, especially after we finished. Like one of the cast members, she got emotional. We just, you know, had so much fun. It was, oh my gosh, we felt like family on set with that.
It felt like fun. I was like, I wish I could have been there, because you know, there are not many, you know, roles, you know, for as women being really together and really having that strong friendship, right, as you know, as Black women sometimes, you know, sometimes people get jealous and stuff, but you saw none of that in the film. They were all together. They were ready to beat up and go down on anybody who messed.
Truly sisters on set and off set. Like, we was like, and when we linked up, we was like, okay, what are we going to do today? What are we going to do before set? So we were family during the film and afterwards too. So we actually still speak now. So,
wow, that's awesome.
Yes. And with the struggle to dilemma, the character, I have to put myself in that character. As the character I play, I had to put myself there. I played Stacy in that one as well. And so the same thing in Girlfriends Reunited with that one, because I'm more of a sweet, loving, caring person. And that one, I didn't care. So I had to put myself in the mode of, hey, this is this. Mm-hmm. Jump into character and just do it. And so, I mean, it became easy. I read the script. I became the character as I read more and studied more of the script. And so that's how I became those characters. That's how I put myself in, you know, in position for those two films. But that one was fun too, but I really had to, you know, I was more serious in the struggle to dilemma.
No, I saw that. That was a great film. I saw that you put your all into that character. I was like, wow, this is, I said, this is different for her. I said, okay, look at her. Because, you know, it was a very powerful film. I watched the first one. The first one was very powerful as well. And the second one equaled that to me. So that was very good job. That was a great film.
Thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome. So who's been your inspiration throughout your career?
Oh my gosh. So throughout my career, my family has been my inspiration. So when I start something, and you know how you have your family as your, they're like, okay, as long as I can keep going, I want to be inspiring to them as well. So they actually inspire me to keep going, because in this industry, you either keep going or you just quit. So, and if you want it, you keep going. So, and I want it. They inspire me. They understand. They get everything. And then also, not just my family, I see other actors from where they started and then where they are now. And so it really inspires me when I see them booking roles. And I'm like, oh, wow, I'm going to get there. Congratulations. It makes me so excited to see when they book a role, because I know I can feel their energy, almost like, wow. I know it must feel so good. So it's very, very, very inspirational to see another actor to keep going. And there's levels to this thing. So
wow.
Either you stop or you keep going. And so they inspire me, and so does my family.
Wow, that is awesome. So, you know, the Sela Actors Agency, they are a really great agency. Everybody there, they're just so nice and kind. Please tell me, how has your time been there? Because I know it must be wonderful, because they're all so nice.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my gosh. They are amazing. I would not trade them for another agency ever. So they're like family. We're all family in the agency. So, I mean, we know one another. I mean, we're all families. Like, we get along very well. The agents, we all get along very well. We're like, oh my gosh, the bond is so tight. We're all family at Sela Actors.
Wow, that is very, very, very rare to find. So Deceptive Intentions, I watched that too. I was like,
oh yeah.
Wow. So what was it like for you to play the detective and / friend? Because I could tell your character in there was, I think, was feeling the guy who was being deceived by the woman he was with. So tell us about that character. What was that like for you?
Oh my gosh. So for that character, she is serious, and she was very protective of her partner. So she know a woman's intuition. We know. So they, the guys can't see what we know.
And so, I know. I know.
So I had her, I had his back. So my character had his back. I was there to let him know, but at the same time, I supported him. So, but I was very serious and also getting into that character as well. I guess my siblings would say, out of all five of us, they would say, you're the most serious one. I don't know why. So being in that character was not hard at all. So yeah. It was like I could jump right into that one, too. So I dive right, dove right in.
You know, but I think you actually have, just to say, you have a good balance of serious and for fun, too, at the same time. You have a good, you have a good balance. So, yeah, I think that's really wonderful. That yeah. really is. So tell me, I know acting can be very demanding. So how do you balance your work and your personal life? How do you balance the two? Because I know it probably can be hard sometimes.
Okay. So, I mean, it can be hard at times, but when you have your family, my family is my personal life. The things that we do are personal. And so, and my acting career is on another level. And so they understand. It's like they get the assignment every time. My kids, I have three little ones. My husband.
Oh, that's so nice.
Oh my gosh. They are amazing. They are very amazing. My family, they support me 100%. My husband, he's always my reader. So when I'm in auditions, they are too. So if I, my husband, he reads for me. My children, if I need them to read, let's say there's a kid that I need to read for me, I will get my one of my kids. And so they're involved 100%. They love it. They understand. My youngest one, he's 7, and he knows when I'm like, guys, I have an audition. I need to go ahead and get this done. And you guys already know, quiet on set. You will hear them say, so in my home, we're like quiet on set. So, and so they're 100% behind me, and they'll go around, all right, mama, about to do an audition, quiet on set, close the doors, go ahead and get the snack you need, take it in your room. They already know. My husband, he's behind me 100%. So, I mean, I bring my family into the business because you'll need support. Whether you have support or not, you keep going. You just drive. If this is what you want, you drive. And so my children, my husband, they are with me 100%, and I'm with them 100%. And so we're in this together. That's how we handled it. So
wow, that is beautiful. It's not just a Robin Lee, it's a family thing too.
Yes.
That is really awesome. You are in great shape for having three children. How do you stay in good shape?
Thank you.
Oh my gosh.
I'm always busy. I was an athlete in school. So
oh really? What did you do?
My dad was a coach. He wasn't going. We had to be in something. So I ran track, I was a cheerleader, and I played basketball.
Oh, wow, that is yeah. awesome. That is a beautiful blessing. I wish I could have done some stuff when I was in school.
Yeah, shoot. In this industry, you have to be ready. You have to be in shape. You never know what role you may get. You have to be ready mentally, physically, and emotionally. So.
Wow, I wouldn't have never thought you had three children.
Yes.
I never would have thought that. My gosh, you are in good shape. Oh my gosh.
Thank you.
So what other upcoming projects can we see from you? Like what is next for Robin Lee? What else can we see
oh
from
my
you?
God. What's next for me? Not only me, I get to work with my daughter in this film. She's 10 years old.
Wow.
Her name is Taylor Lee. She's an actress too, and she's represented by Selah Actors as well. We're both going to be in this film. It's called Chronology. And so,
wow, that's awesome.
The director is Ricky Tyree. He's on Facebook. He's on IG. It's going to be amazing. We're going to be filming this soon, like within the next 2 weeks. We are prepared. We're ready. And so it's going to be fun because I get to film this with my favorite girl, my baby girl, my only girl, my daughter. So I'm excited. She's excited. It's going to be great on set. And so it's called Chronology. So, you know.
Wow, that is awesome. You get to work with the most beautiful person in the world to you. And that is such a beautiful, yes, that is such a beautiful, beautiful blessing from God, you know. And I can tell your passion for acting. Have you always had that? Have you always wanted to be an actor and an actress? Have you always wanted to do that? Because I can see this is like a driving force for you. And that's such a beautiful thing.
There's a story behind this, but actually, I wanted to be a model. And
so I know you have a strong faith in the Lord, you know, and so do I. So please tell me how the Lord has pushed you through the good times and the bad times when you weren't so sure about things.
Okay. First of all, I think I have to pray about a lot of things because, you know, how we want to use our own minds, our fleshly minds. And we're like, okay, I just want to do this. I want to do this.
Yes.
And so especially with my acting, being that I actually started maybe 4 years ago because I was younger when I started with the modeling thing. And I'm from Tennessee. And so there's not a big industry in Tennessee with acting at all. So my husband and I, we moved here, and long story short, I don't know how it happened, and I'm sure it was God. I know it was. Out of nowhere, I received a Facebook messenger from somebody, and they asked me about a play and everything. I mean, we're not friends. I don't have mutual friends with this person or anything. None of it. I'm like, who is this lady? Who is this lady? A play? I'm like, okay, I wanted to be a model and you know, do commercials and things like that, but I didn't expect to be as deep as I am now in the industry. And so I contacted a lady, and we talked a little bit, and then next thing you know, I'm in her play, and I'm like, okay. And so, mind you, I'm in Georgia with my family, and I'm at home with my children all the time during this time. Anyways, and my husband worked. And it's like after that play, and I did some background work, I connected with someone and she gave me information about background work. So that whole week I had something lined up. Again, I was a stay-at-home mom and wife. I didn't know what it was like again. So to be out there, to mingle with grown-ups at that. So that whole week I had like four things lined up. I had to play. I had at least three background roles just to get my feet wet. And so after that, I got home. After that, everything was done. I'm done filming background, the play, everything's over. And I'm like, wow, that feels good. It's like a light. Like I felt like a cloud move. Like this is what life is. Like outside of my family, and I love them so much, but the grown-up side, oh, this is what it's like to mingle with other people. And I wanted more. And when I say it did not stop coming, it was coming back to back. And that's how I know it was God to bring me back in this industry. And I was consistently booking. People were reaching out to me. And I did auditions. And then even with Girlfriends Reunited and Deceptive Intentions, The Struggle to the Dilemma, I know it was God because he was like, hey, I want you in this film. I want you in this film. And I'm like, okay. And they just, the roles just kept coming. Just kept coming. And so that's how I know it was God. And I had to pray about it. I was like, okay, Lord. And it was like, God was just sitting it on a table for me. Here you go. Here you go. Here you go. And it just kept on going. And so,
That, you know what, that is really awesome. Cause I always say when he opens up doors, it's like a flood. All of a sudden it just comes pouring and pouring and pouring in. That, you know,
I'm still wowed. I think about this now. I'm like, wow, how people kept telling me, hey, it may take some time. It may take some time. And I'm like, and I had that drive. And every time somebody told me, hey, it may take you about 5, 10, 15 years before you're actually there, in my mind, because I didn't want to be disrespectful, but in my mind, I was like, not me, because I had a drive for it. Once that light turned on, like, this is for me, there was a drive. I'm like, no, I'm not stopping. There's no breaks. And so I just kept on going.
Wow. You know, that really is amazing. And now my last question for you is, what words of wisdom would you give anyone who wants to come into this industry?
Words of wisdom for anybody. You know, it's for you once you get your feet wet. I can't say, hey, I'm going to go and try this out and I don't know what it's like until I do it. I can't say you already going to know before. Some people know before. Some people don't know until they actually try it out. Once you try it out and you know it's for you, you have to have a passion. You can't say, oh, let me just go on and do this real quick. Let me just go on and do this real quick. Let me just get this role and be like, okay, let me go ahead and get this out the way. You have to come mentally, physically, spiritually. You have to come ready, period. For every character is different. I say keep going. There's going to be times when you're going to be rejected. There's going to be plenty of no's. And I got this. I forgot from whom. But in the industry, we always say as actors, when we receive auditions, it's something to celebrate. You know how many people submitted for their role? And then also the breakdown they have to give, like a few people get an audition back. That's something to celebrate. And once you do the audition, you have to submit it and then you forget it. Because you may not get the role and you may get the role. But it's only one person can get the role out of so many people submitting. I say you keep driving. Even if you rejected one, you rejected two, you rejected three, you keep going. If it's your passion, you know it is, because you will keep going. There'll be times mentally you'd be like, I'm ready to give up mentally. But then again, you got to think about what drove you to this point. What drove you to keep driving? You just keep going. Don't give up. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. It happened for so many. If it happened for so many, for me, it's going to happen for the person who wants to be an actor or in the industry.
Wow. Those are amazing words of wisdom. And I want to thank you for all that you do, because you are an amazing actress and you're going to go so far in this industry. Your star is really shining bright. You're making a lot of noise out there. And, you know, I just want to thank you for taking the time and coming on here and being on here. And I feel like it's an honor to have interviewed you right now.
Essence, thank you so much for having me. Thank you so much.
Cause you know, at Black Label and myself, we believe in people who are talented, who are really pushing forward, who are really making noise, and who are doing things that need to be said out there. Like those movies, like Girlfriends United, that's how real girlfriends should act towards each other and not the opposite. And, you know, even the struggle, it tells you the things that happen out there in the streets that do need to be brought to light. And this stuff is not to be sugarcoated or anything like that. It's important to know these things that are going on and to bring it up to the forefront. So I just want to congratulate you on everything that you do. You are a beautiful light, a beautiful individual. And I just want to thank you. And, you know, we want to put you, the Black Essence Magazine, on our cover. So, be looking for that soon.
Awesome.
So
I look forward to it. Thank you so much.
No, thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. And I just pray you have a beautiful, blessed day. And please keep going. I want to bring you back on here to see more of your projects and everything that you're doing.
Most definitely. Yes, I'll be ready for it. So you guys let me know when. I'll be ready. I do appreciate you. I thank you guys so much. And also, you have an amazing day. And be blessed as always.
Yes, you too. You too, sis. Thank you so much.
Bye.
Wow, you guys, isn't she amazing? She is such an amazing light and an amazing spirit. So please go check out all her movies. Go check them out. They are on Tubi, www.tubi.com. I'm going to have all of her movies in the description box. So please go check out Robin Lee, because she is doing amazing, amazing, beautiful things. So please, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, just click on the red dot right there, say subscribe, just hit it and you'll be subscribed. You'll be notified when I go live. You'll be notified on the new things that are coming up. So I want to thank you guys for tuning in today, and remember to keep pushing forward. Keep pushing forward to your dreams, and remember, anything is possible. You have purpose. Never let anyone make you think you have no promise or purpose. So thank you guys for tuning in today. Love you. God bless you all.
Chain, when it round my neck, I'm taking my मेरी बातचीत पढ़े न फर्क चाहे मिले मुझे हार चीज स्ट्रगल वाले दिनों में करे कोई याद नहीं अब करते हैं कॉल जो पहले थे मेरे साथ नहीं छोड़ा साथ लेकिन कोई बड़ी बात नहीं तभी देश रखी मैंने हेटरों की हार्ट बीट बेटा ऑन द टॉप